Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Maria and on my channel I create videos around everything nursing. I am trying to get to 10,000 subscribers, so I'd really appreciate it if you guys subscribe to my channel. If you found this video helpful, then make sure you give this video a like. So as you guys have obviously guessed from the title of the video, in this video I'm going to be sharing the pros and the cons of being a nurse, the pros and the cons of a career in nursing. Now I do want to say these are not necessarily what I believe to be the pros and cons of nursing. These are just the pros and cons that I found on the internet, and then I'm going to add my commentary, I'm going to add my two cents on it, because some of them are kind of like false. Well, not false, but some of them like paint a really pretty picture, but when you delve into it, it's like, oh, it isn't really like that. And some of them, like particularly some of the cons, some people may think that that is a con, but depending on what your life is set up like, depending on what it is that you want from life, it might not actually be a con, it can actually be a pro. It might not be a pro, it might be a con. So I'm just going to kind of give my two cents on it, because when you're looking at these pros and cons, they kind of seem a bit 2D. I'm going to make it 3D. I'm going to make it three-dimensional. I'm going to make it relatable. So let's start. As long as you're fit, as long as you have your NMC pin, you will always have a job if that's what you want. So the first pro is that a career in nursing is in very high demand. Yes, that is definitely a pro of being a nurse or having a career in nursing. Wherever you go, you will always find a job. Like, I could literally quit my job today and find a job tomorrow. And that, in a sense, is quite scary, because it just goes to show that everyone is replaceable. But it is also quite freeing to know that actually, if I don't like this environment, I could actually just quit and I could be in a new job within a week's time, even within a couple of days' time. Since the pandemic has started, there's been more people applying to nursing degrees, which I was actually quite surprised at. I thought it would put people off, but I think the job security that comes with the high demand of being a nurse kind of trumps all the other cons of being a nurse. And as long as, you know, the people of the land continue to get sicker, as long as there's more people living with long-term health conditions, the demand for nurses will always be there. We know that at this point in life, the health and social care system isn't as advanced, isn't quite where we want it to be. As we look at this pro, it seems like it's a really good thing, and in a sense it kind of is, but really it kind of is just a reflection of deeper, more concerning issues that I have just mentioned. The second pro of being a nurse is the diversity and the variety. You have so many options that you can choose from. When people graduate and get the NMC pin, you can work in a hospital, you can work in a mental health facility, you can work as a GP nurse, you can work as a HIV nurse, you can work as an IVF nurse, you can work in a cruise ship, you can work in the army. Those are the first things that come to mind. But honestly, guys, the variety is endless. You see, when you see them YouTube videos, when people say, I've quit nursing, they don't actually mean, 90% of the time, they don't actually mean that they've quit nursing. What they really mean is that they have left bedside nursing. What they really mean is that they've left the traditional nursing environment, and what they actually mean is that they're probably just going to specialize elsewhere. Maybe they've gone to specialize in nursing informatics, maybe they've gone into nursing insurance, maybe they've gone to work as a nurse lawyer, maybe they've gone to work in the pharmaceutical industry as a nurse. 9 times out of 10, they don't actually mean that they've left nursing as a whole, they just mean that they have left bedside nursing. So that's definitely one pro of a career in nursing. If you've been working in this hospital, in this role for like 10 years, and you're thinking, I want a complete change in my career, but I don't actually want to go back to university and do another 3-year degree, you can kind of just take like a CPD course, or you could take like a short diploma and make that transition, and you're still in nursing, you haven't completely left it, still keep your NMC pin, but you are working in a completely, you could say a completely different industry, but still within the nursing niche. There are so many specialities to choose from. I do want to quickly say, I really hope that some nursing associates or some prospective nursing associate students are watching this video. But I do want to say, in terms of specializing, I don't think it applies to people who became a registered nurse via the nursing associate route. So if you are, you know, a college student, a sixth form student, and you've gone on to do the nursing associate role, and now you're working as a band 4 nursing associate, and then you do a 1-year program to top up to a band 5 resident nurse, you may not be able to specialize. I heard from powers beyond me that people who become resident nurses via the nursing associate role are not able to specialize. They can only work as general nurses. If you do have any more information about this, then make sure you put it in the comments box below, because I am genuinely interested to know. So now we're going to go over to the cons of being a nurse. The first con of being a nurse is the long hours. And remember what I said at the beginning of the video, what some people may consider pros may actually be cons, and what people consider cons may actually be pros. But the first well-cited con on the internet of being a nurse is the long hours. You are working 12, people say 12 hours, but it ain't 12 hours. You're at work for 13 hours, but because you get an hour break, people say 12 hour shift. But I'm going to say 13 hour shift, because we're going to call it for what it is. And when I tell you, bro, those 13 hour shifts are not easy. And the thing about being a nurse or working a 13 hour shift as a nurse, in comparison to, say, for example, working a 13 hour shift in a factory, is that mentally, your mind has to be on 100 from the beginning of the shift all the way to the end of the shift. There are some jobs where you can kind of turn your brain off and work on autopilot, but as a nurse, you can't turn your brain off and work on autopilot. Your brain has to be actively processing information, taking in information, putting the information out, doing this, doing that. So yeah, you have to be on job the whole of your 12, the whole of your 13 hour shift. Now, the reason why I say some people see it as a con, I mean some people see it as a pro, is because if you are working 13 hour shifts, generally you're only working three of the 7 days of the week. So you're working 3 days and then you've got 4 days off. But really, that isn't how it works. The second con of being a nurse that I'm going to share in this video, and this is a con, there's no way of wording it as a pro. The second con that I'm going to share is emotional burnout. Like, if this is not the truth. Like, physical burnout, yeah, go home, relax, sleep, have a massage, yes. But emotional burnout, like, think about it. As nurses, you literally witness almost every single type of human suffering, sometimes almost on a daily basis. Imagine working as a nurse and being around sick people all the time. And I know nurses come with that healing energy, but sometimes you are in an environment where that sort of healing energy isn't supported. I think back to one placement that I had as a student nurse. It was actually at a hospice, and like, yes, I was around dying people because I was at a hospice, but that environment supported it. So even though I was, you know, around dying people, I was, you know, with dead people all the time, sometimes it felt like it because that environment supported it. I think that environment, I think it was like a private healthcare institution, I think it was a private healthcare provider. So they kind of had the money. They really, really made sure that they looked after their nurses' well-being. This emotional burnout can be a reality very, very early on. Sometimes when people think of nursing burnout, they think of nursing burnout occurring 10 years down the line, 15 years down the line, 20 years down the line. No, if you're working in a very good healthcare environment where they actually care for your mental health and where they actually care for your physical health beyond just words, but they actually do it with actions, yes, burnout may be delayed, you know, 20, 30 years on into your career. Whereas if you're working in a healthcare environment or with a healthcare, you know, business where nursing, mental health, nursing well-being isn't their priority, emotional burnout could be a thing that you see within 1 year, within 2 years of qualifying. If you're a nurse, what, you're one person, yeah, and you've got 13 patients, you can't have a nurse person, you can't have a nurse patient relationship with all of those 13 patients in a typical ward environment. Recognize emotional burnout and try your best to act accordingly, because emotional burnout doesn't just manifest itself emotionally, it manifests itself physically, it manifests itself spiritually, it manifests itself mentally. Like, in every realm of life, emotional burnout will have a negative impact. So make sure, if you are experiencing emotional burnout, or even if you're not experiencing emotional burnout, make sure you just act accordingly. So there we have it, two pros of being a nurse, and that is, a career in nursing is in high demand. The second pro is the variety of nursing roles that you can apply for. And the two cons that I've shared in this video of being a nurse are the long hours and the emotional burnout. If you want to see another video like this, then make sure you give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.